Let us read Acts of the Apostles chapter 1 verse 4 and 5. Acts of the Apostles chapter 1 verse 4 and 5. We read like this. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Jesus is requesting his disciples, commanding his disciples, ordered them. It's an order. He ordered them not to leave Jerusalem. No way. No matter what happens, you should never leave Jerusalem. Be in Jerusalem. Because here you are going to receive the Holy Spirit. Here you are going to be anointed by the power of the Holy Spirit. We again read, even in the Gospel of Luke chapter 24 verse 47 onwards, we read like this. Luke chapter 24 verse 47 onwards we read, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. Beginning from Jerusalem, the proclamation of forgiveness of sins should be proclaimed from Jerusalem. Verse 48, you are witnesses of these things. Verse 49, and see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high. What is the speciality of this? Why do they need to stay in Jerusalem, in the city itself? Because that is where they are going to receive the Holy Spirit. There is a reason. Jerusalem is the place where everything started. And is going to start even Pentecost. Everything is going to start. You know why the reason? The reason is this. Jerusalem is a very important place in the salvation history. The whole Old Testament is completed in Jerusalem. The Holy Temple is in Jerusalem. The Word of God is in Jerusalem. And the Mount Zion is in Jerusalem. And the Ark of the Covenant was found in Jerusalem. The tablets of Ten Commandments were also kept in Jerusalem. And all the Passover was supposed to be celebrated in and is celebrated in Jerusalem. And Jesus' passion took place in Jerusalem. The blood of Jesus is sprinkled in Jerusalem. Jesus carried the cross in Jerusalem. And Jesus died on Mount Calvary in Jerusalem. And Jesus is resurrected in Jerusalem. So stay the whole salvation history. Stay in salvation history. You will receive the Holy Spirit. What does it mean? Be attached. Be meditating on this mystery of salvation. Then you will be filled by the Holy Spirit. If anybody want to be filled by the Holy Spirit, don't go anywhere else. Be in the presence of God. Be in the salvation history. Read the Word of God. Repent about your sinful life. Meditate on your passion. Meditate on the passion, death and resurrection of Jesus. Meditate on the salvation history. Read the Word of God. Read the Ark of the Covenant, the commandments. Read the message of the Lord. And wash yourself in the precious blood of Jesus. And then you will be filled with the Holy Spirit. So this is what the Word of God by saying be in Jerusalem means. It's not about a special place. It is about something more. Be in him. That is what we read in the Word of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 2. Saint Paul said, 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 2. We read like this. For I desired to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. What does it mean? Saint Paul decided to be in Jerusalem. That's all. Saint Paul decided to be in Jerusalem. My dear brothers and sisters, you may be a politician, you may be a doctor, nurse, or maybe a priest or preacher, or you may be a student or teacher, whoever maybe you are, be in Jerusalem. What does it mean? for I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. When you are centered or focused on Eucharist, while focused on Jesus Christ, then you are in Jerusalem, because Jerusalem is the focus of all salvation history. All the things in the salvation history happened in Jerusalem, and Jesus said, be there.